beginning to come into that place of ideal postural alignment. We've got the hand weights today. Breathe in through the nostrils and then breathe out as if you're blowing through a straw. So that's a narrowed opening. And when you do that, we can just think a little bit more about the belly muscles engaging. Inhale, expand the rib cage. Exhale as if you're blowing through the straw. And bring your attention to the layer of muscles deep in the front of the low belly area. And then let's circle those shoulders on the back of the body. Ooh, crunch, groan, grind. So you feel the shoulder blades really move on the back of you. And then the elbows. Big circles. So make sure you feel like you're drawing a circle with the elbow, the point of your elbow on the wall at the side of you. And then rest the arms and we'll do the full arm. Inhale and exhale. And so notice as you move the arms, particularly if you do have weights in the hands, that this displacement force is what we're generating. And that calls upon the muscles of the center to keep us still and stable. So you can tune your mind into that sensation that you feel naturally in the middle of your body and just reinforce it with conscious connection. So come to the side and we'll bend the waist. Remember, we are in between two panes of glass, so you're not going forwards or backwards. The eyes look ahead of you, not up, not down. And all the while, as you bend down to the side, you're thinking of growing up out of the ground. So we'll add the arm optional beside the ear. Remember, anything that your body feels is inappropriate, feel free to modify or leave out. Pain is not what we are striving for in this session at all. And make this one the last one on each side. Do one more on each side. Perfect. So let's bring the arms out in front and the bicep curls. So notice when the arms are out in front of you, that's when you're going to feel the abdominal muscles switch on more strongly. And that's the sensation that we want to kind of tap into as we move through the whole of the session. And last time. So this time, arms beside you. Let's come up onto tiptoes. Whoops, balancing. Tiptoe raises. Open the ankles forwards so you're not going off to the side at all. And grow the top of the head to the ceiling. And then we'll do some running with the arms. Nice and controlled, smooth, flowing motion. That's it, very good. And one more. Perfect. So let's come out into our squat, the deeper squat. Really feel loaded into the heels. Feel that connection between the heels and the gluteal muscles so that as you feel weighted in the heels, just a little bit more energy into the glutes will be apparent. Inhale down, exhale lift. And so let's do two more. And then last one. So feet apart, into that V shape. Really a zipper up the inner thighs, feeling that inner thigh connection. So we're going to hold the arms out in front and we're going to squat, open one arm to the side. So it's a plie. And then as you tiptoe raise, open the arm to the ceiling. So to the side, to the ceiling. That's it. Remember, you are moving at the shoulder joint. And that you don't want the arm, the shoulders creeping up around the ears, even as the arm is lifting. So this long ballerina, swan-like neck, and keep the elbow just unlocked so that you know your elbows are never fully locked when you're doing resistance. So I'm opening to the side, I'm opening to the top. Last time, this way, and then to the top. So we're going to change the arms. So it's the other side, and then lift the arm. That's it. Other side. Lift the arm. Out to the side. This is a lot for your shoulders. I know that you are starting to feel this in the arms, round about now. And two. And last one. Very good. So rest the arms, take the feet wide. We'll do our squat and press. So inhale down, exhale left. And it's slower on the way down. Two, three, press up on one. Down, two, three, press up on one. Down, two, three, press up. Make sure the knees go to the second toes. Down, 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 push up. So I'm bringing in a pause at the bottom. Hold, press up. So you are very still, just for a moment, and then press up from there so that we've totally stopped moving. And then press up, lower, 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 pause, press. Yeah, lower, 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 pause, press. And again, feel the bottom muscles in the thigh muscles. And last time, and press. Very good. So let's come with the elbows at the side. Open the palms to the side. I really want you to feel the shoulder blades on the back of you gently glide a little in towards each other. Inhale as you open, exhale as you close. You could do the opposite. It's not the end of the world with this. Very good. So then we can open. Reach the arms to the sides, and I'm turning my palms to face a bit more backwards. And then the elbows in and in. So it's open, turn, rotate the arms, rotate on the return. So it's a spiral kind of a motion. Open. The rotation is just me turning my hands so that my palms face back. And then on the way in, I bring them the other way. So open, rotate the palms back. That's it, in and open. Very good. So lift to the side now. And we're going to come and balance on one leg as we do this. So that we're challenging the stabilizing muscles around the center as we balance on one leg. Now let's lift, rotate, lower, lower. Lift, rotate, lower, lower. Again, we should be able to balance on one leg for a whole minute. Lift, rotate, lower, lower. So you can practice that while you're waiting for the kettle. I haven't timed my kettle actually, I wonder. I must do that. Last time this way. Down, down. We'll swap legs. And same thing on the other side. So hovering the knee, lift, lift. This time we go all the way up and then it's down, down, down. Lift, 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 down, down, down. And lift, 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 lower, lower, lower. Two more. Last one. Lift, lower, lower, lower. Lower the legs. Hands behind the head. So this is elbows in towards each other. So you're almost hugging your ears with your arms, and then the lift and lower. Stand up tall, abs engage, tail to the ground, eyes look ahead of you. Four more. Two and one. Very good, rest it down. So let's roll down from the top. Soften the knees as you see fit. Breathe in at the bottom. Breathe out. Engage the abdominals as you uncurl. Restack the spine and then reset the shoulder blades. Breathe in. Breathe out. Soften the knees, arms fall forwards away from the body. Scoop the abdominal contents. Breathe in at the bottom. Breathe out. Uncurl. Restack. And reset. Okay, so we're coming to lie on the back. And I'm giving you the option to use the weights. So take your time as you approach that. You can always hook the fingers in behind the knees as you lower yourself down. So I'm resting with my hands on top of the balls. That's why the spherical balls are quite nice to rest on top of. And then we're going to do our pelvic rocking. So beginning with that rolling of the marble, that's it, good, from the pubic bone in towards the navel and then back towards the pubic bone so that you are feeling this flattening of the back as you exhale and then a gentle arching of the spine as you inhale. So flattening the back as you roll in, exhale, inhale, rolling away. And then come to rest in the mid position. So we're going to slide one leg away along the ground and then bring it back to the center. And all the while, be very aware of the bony landmarks of the pelvis. So that's the pointy hip bones and the pubic bone. Totally still as you move only at the hip joint. And connecting the mind with the muscles at the center. And just be very aware of the pelvic floor. We're never pressing down into the pelvic floor. Just do one more on the other side. And then we're going to hover the hands above the shoulders.
First of all, just the arms reaching away overhead. And we're not touching the ground with this. I don't want you to touch the ground, just to reach the arms away overhead. And kind of notice the effect that has on the musculature in the front of the body. So I'm aiming for about 45 degrees at the shoulder joint. And then we can add that leg slide if we wanted to, so that you're alternating legs. Breathe out as you reach, breathe in on the return. And the tailbone is very still. The pelvis isn't rocking side to side or front to back. And the back of the rib cage really sinking down into the ground so that you never arch away from the ground as you move the arms and the legs. So make this one the last one. And then rest the arms beside you, a little out to the sides. Glue the legs together and rock the knees side to side, moving at the waist. So the legs are glued together, touching. Inhale as you turn to the side. Exhale on the return journey. And feel that bringing out sensation at the level of the waist. Turn the eyes to look over the opposite shoulder. So again, we're getting that spiral movement. And make this one the last one. Walking the feet hip distance apart, resting the arms alongside the body, heels a little closer to the bottom, and let's roll the pelvis and then peel the spine up and away, coming to rest on the shoulder blades. Breathe in at the top, breathe out as you lower, bit by bit, bone by bone, all the way to the tailbone. Breathe in at the bottom, breathe out, peeling the spine up and away. Breathe in at the top, breathe out as you lower the body, bit by bit, bone by bone, all the way to the ground. So raising the arms above the shoulders, this time peel the spine up and away, reach the arms overhead, lower the body bit by bit, and then bring the arms back to the vertical. So with or without the weights, reach overhead, lower the body bit by bit, and then bring the arms to the vertical. Do that one more time, peeling the spine up and away. Breathe in, breathe out as you lower bit by bit, bone by bone, rib by rib. That's it. Rest with the arms above the shoulders now. And we're going to open one knee to the side. And then the other knee, taking it in turns. And inhale as you open. Exhale as you close. Tailbone heavy into the ground. So that you really get that sense of weightedness through the sacrum. Make sure your arms are straight above your shoulders for this. And then we're going to open the arm to the opposite side. Again, that elbow is just unlocked. Now make sure that when you do open the knee to the side, the pelvis is not joining in at all. So you've got a tray of very expensive drinks on the front of you, and you definitely don't want to spill them. And back to the center. Chin is in, neck is long. Open the arm and the opposite leg. So just notice how that feels in the body as you do it. See if you can process what's happening, what needs to happen. Make this one the last one. Very good. So I'm hovering one leg to tabletop next, and then lower it down. So you could have the arms resting above the shoulders. You could have the arms resting alongside the body. You could use the weights or not, and it's for you to choose. And actually, now for this bit, I'm just allowing my hands to rest very slightly higher than the shoulders, that is, further towards my head. So I feel a little bit of engagement down through the back of my arm towards the armpit as I hold my hands, just very slightly aiming overhead and alternating legs. So now it's hover one leg into the air, and we're going to reach out the opposite arm and leg. So with or without the balls, with or without the arms, I said balls, I mean weights. Breathe out, reach out, breathe in, come in. So you're alternating. No, you're not alternating. I tell a complete lie. We're on the same side. Breathe out, reach out, breathe in, come in. Make sure you're aiming the leg about 45 degrees at the hip joint. Same with the shoulder, actually. You're not aiming to touch the ground overhead. Chin is in, neck is long, ribs are glued, sinking down, tailbone heavy, and just feel that muscular sheet in the front of you. Now, swap legs, same thing on the other side. One leg reaches and the opposite arm joins in. So you can do it with or without the weight, with or without the arm. Just pick a version that speaks to you and breathe out as you open the gap wide. Breathe in on the return. And now lower the leg. So one leg can lift into the air, and then I'm giving you the option to bring two legs simultaneously. So you can do any of the previous versions or tapping down. So this time I'm taking two arms overhead as I tap the tips of the toes, one foot at a time, to the ground. So breathe out, reach. Definitely having the weights in the hands brings a lot more focus into that muscular sheet in the front of you. So we've got the deep layer of muscles engaging in the background the whole time. Never arch the back away from the ground. Tap. Only if you wanted to, sending that leg reaching long, and then the other leg. So breathe out, reach out, breathe in, come in. And this is the higher level. So you can always step it back a level. Just make sure the back is never arching. And two more. And last one. Perfect. So lower the legs. Lower the arms, have the hips and knees apart, so that hips and feet apart. I don't know what I'm talking about. Knees and feet apart. The hips are always going to be apart, aren't they? They're never coming together, those hips. So rocking the knees to the side with the knees apart, feet apart. Perfect. So last of all, I'm giving you the option, and you can do the version on the ground or the version in the air. So it's opening one knee to the side and one arm. So opposite arm and leg opens to the side. Inhale as you open, exhale as you close. And with the back of the body in that neutral shape. Breathe in as you open, out as you close. And the pelvis is still. You've got that tray of very expensive drinks, remember. And make this one the last one. Wonderful. So take the body straight and I've dropped the weights, reaching overhead. You can allow the back to arch just a little away from the ground as you do this stretch. So arching the back to stretch is not prohibited. Very good. So hug the knees in, rock around, massage the back of you. Inhale, exhale, roll yourselves up to sit. So we're going to do the half roll backs, and the key things here are that we're starting this movement up on the bottom bones, and then the movement is initiated from these pelvis, so that rather than, you know, moving the head first, you move the pelvis, rocking the pelvis backwards. So you're rocking the pelvis away from the thighs. Then we come forwards and keep the flexed posture, bring the nose to the knees, and then we come up. So inhale in the upright, exhale, round the low back, rock the pelvis away, breathe in, hold. Breathe out, dive forwards in that flexed position, and then uncurl the spine. Restack, inhale, exhale, rocking the pelvis away. Inhale, hold. Exhale, dive forwards, and then uncurl. Restack. So you can do that with the weights in the hands. You can hold the hands out in front of you like you've got a fictional beach ball between the palms, or you can hold the weights. Sit up tall, inhale, exhale, rock the pelvis away. Inhale, hold. Exhale, dive forwards. Inhale, restack. Exhale, rock away. Inhale, hold. Exhale, dive forwards. Inhale, restack. Perfect. So we can add to that a rotation. So as we rock away, this time rotate, and I'm leading with the elbow. That's it. And then reach forward. So it's a pull, a bit like you're pulling the rubber band, really. Same thing to the other side, and then come up. So rather than four phases of movement, this is two. We combine that rocking away with rotation, reach, restack, and then do the same thing on the other side. So you're rocking away with rotation, reach as you restack. So with or without the weights, back, and then restack. Good. Inhale, elbow back. Exhale. One more on each side. Rock away. Restack. And try not to be too rounded in the upper back. And restack. Perfect. Let's come onto the front. So this is when you can lean on these round balls. Obviously, you couldn't do that with the dumbbells. It's not possible. So it's optional, of course, if you wanted to, if you've got the balls, and if you don't, then obviously it's not optional. Inhale, sink into the gentle hollow shape. Exhale, round. And really think of this movement coming from the tail end. Inhale into the hollow. We want long, smooth curves through the spine. Inhale the hollow. Exhale. Round, look and lift. Inhale. Gaze ahead of you. Exhale, round, look. So let's give you the option to tuck the toes. And this time, as you round the spine, the option to lift and hover the knees. And then lower and gently into that hollow shape. So breathe out, round, look, lift, hover the knees. And then slowly lower as you inhale into the hollow shape. Breathe out, round, look, lift. Breathe in, sink into the hollow. Perfect. So come to the mid position. I'm coming off the balls now. And this really does only work if you have the weighted balls, but you do exactly the same thing without them. So I'm holding it at the back of my knee, which is a bit of a trick. And then lifting the sole of the foot towards the ceiling. So breathe out as you lift, breathe in as you lower. I'm tapping the knee down briefly, and then breathe out as you lift, breathe in as you lower. So you're kind of holding onto that ball at the back of your knee if you have a ball. And they are very versatile. I do like them. So you're really getting that sense of squeezing the bottom cheek and focus your mind on the junction between the thigh and the bottom muscles. So let's add now the rounding of the back, that cat. I'm bringing my knee to my nose and then the sole of the foot to the ceiling, and it's only a very gentle hollow or arch of the spine. So lift the foot, round, knee to nose, lift the foot, round, knee to nose, lift the foot. Last time, knee to nose, lift the foot. Lower it down, give your wrists a rest. And now I'm lifting the same leg to the side. I'm still holding the ball at the back of the knee, or just hold the leg at 90 degrees. Lifting to the side. It's really tempting to kind of rock the body around. Make sure you're neutral so that you are, you're not rounding at all. It's tempting to round your back. So be in that neutral shape, lifting. Two more to the side and last one. Very good. Now, come up for a second, just give your wrists a little rest, and we can do our water skiing while we give the wrists a rest. So with or without weights in the hands, water skiing, hinging at the knees. This is called the knee stretch, and it is quite a lot of strain on the knees, so do be very aware if this is not feeling like it's doing you good. Then maybe it's not for you. And you can obviously do with or without weights. And we won't do too much of this. Very good. Okay, so it's now we're moving to the other side and back onto all fours. Lifting, I've got my sole of my foot, tapping the knee down, lifting the sole of the foot to make a impression on the ceiling, but moving without disrupting this alignment through the spine at all. So breathe out as you extend at the hip, soften the knees, elbows, fingers spread wide. Bottom muscles engage. One more this way, and then we're going to round knee to the nose and then send the tip of the toe to the ceiling. As you drop into a gentle hollow, round knee to the nose, gentle hollow, toe to the ceiling. Breathe out. Breathe in. That's it. Last one, this way. Round tip of the toe. So it's lifting to the side and keeping the back of the body. Ooh, I laid an egg. keeping the back of the body. Ooh, that's interesting. It doesn't want to do it on this. What's wrong with me? There we go. The back of the body very still and neutral. So you can see, you should see that even though I'm lifting to the side, I'm not tipping my pelvis. Keep the head lifting in line with the back of you. Keep the abdominals engaging and the pelvic floor. Never, never feel like you're pressing down into the pelvic floor. Unlock the elbows. Do two more this way. And then last one. Very good. So if you've got the ball, take it out as you reach, set the seat to the feet, the arms reach ahead of you, belly to the thighs. Breathe in, expand the rib cage, the back of the body. We're coming to lie on the front. And if you've got the balls, you can have one either side. So let's press first of all with the arms alongside you. Remember your support for the forehead and make sure that the lumbar spine is in that neutral alignment. We're going to hover the forehead, the breastbone, open the shoulders, and then hover the hands. And I've got them parallel with the ground, and then slowly lower. So thinking very much of the shoulder blades on the rib cage, the muscles of the upper back, hover, lengthen, and then lower. So breathe out, reach, lengthen, hover. Ooh, breathe in as you lower. And the drop down. Breathe out as you lift. That's it. Long line. Top of the head. Oh, she's back. Good. Top of the head, reaching away from the tips of the toes, palms face to the ground. And there's a little bit of energy in the bottom muscles, keeping the spine in that neutral place. Grow tall from the top of the head all the way to the tips of the toes. Reach, lengthen and hover. And lower. So this time I'm bringing my hands into that W shape. And if you've got the balls, you can rest your hand on the balls. Hands, two hands. Hovering the forehead and the breastbone away. And then reaching one arm. Now I'm rolling the arm along the top of the ball. And then bring it back and lower it down. Or you're just hovering the arm without the ball, yes? And then lower it down. So hover, reach, lengthen, Roll the hand along the top of the ball and then back in as you lower and then swap. So you're alternating arms. And then of course, if you wish to, you could do two arms together, float hover, reach the two arms back and then lower. And again, float hover, roll on the tops of the balls. Chin is in, neck is long, elbows down and lower. Do that one more time, reach, lengthen the arms, hover away and lower it down. Perfect. So bend the knees 90 degrees, rock your feet like windscreen wipers. And let's come up to lie on the side. One long line, arm up under the head, high on the hip, spacing the waist. And I've got the ball here in front of me. So you could use your hand weights for some of this. I'm going to lift and lower the top leg. And have energy in the front of you. Remember the shoulders are stacked, one on top of each other, and the shoulder, top shoulder is away from the ears. So the neck feels lovely and long. Imagine resistance between the legs as you press the legs down together. And all the while, when we do these leg exercises, really have that sense of drawing the kneecap up on the front of the leg, activating the thigh muscles so that you feel all the muscles in your leg actually switching on to make the leg one long line. Come to the top, hold and draw circles. 4, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and the other way, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and lower it down. Perfect. So we're going to give you the choice to lift two legs simultaneously. Now you could just remain with the top leg or two legs simultaneously. Relax the shoulders, whatever you're doing, and have your hand resting in front of you. Now, the option with the ball, if you're lifting two legs together, is that this is a shape that you can hold between your ankles. And I don't know that it would work with a dumbbell. It might just not be very comfortable. So just to show you that, Mandy's giving it a try. Oh dear. Yeah, so some of them are covered in neoprene, aren't they? And they're a bit more sort of forgiving, I suppose. So you can judge that for yourself. But two leg lifting, it's a lot for the top waist. We want to feel like this is about the waist more than the legs. So you should feel the top waist work hard as you lift. And then make this one the last one and lower it down. Good, taking my ball back. Hips and knees. And we're going to do our salute of the arm as we open the leg. Remember, I'm not going all the way to the vertical. Here at the vertical, my arm is doing nothing. It's all just gravity. So if I'm off the vertical just a little more towards the top of my head, then my arm's working the whole time. Of course, bear in mind if this generates unnecessary tension around the neck, if that's your nemesis, which it is for lots of people, then you might just be better to miss the arm and focus on the leg.
Relax the shoulder down away from the ears. So even though the arm is up, the shoulder is not coming to hug around the ear. So think of shoulder down, extend and bend the elbow. Yeah, that's better. Good. Two feet is an option, float, and then lift and lower. So remember to pick your poison and only choose the moves that feel suited to you. Two and one. Very good. So let's push on up to the heel of the hand. Remember, you can do this on the forearm if wrists are an issue for you. I'm making a triangle. Heel of the hand, knee, hip. I'm pushing out of the ground. Inhale to prepare. Exhale, lift up and over. So this is when you could hold the weight if you wanted to. But like I said to you in the beginning, if holding the weight interferes with the quality of the movement, then it's better not to do it. Push out of the ground, grow. Very good, breathe out. And last time, perfect. So triceps, fingers face forwards. This is when we allow the tummy muscles to have a little rest. And rest on the weight, rest the weight on the arms and feel the backs of the arms getting some work in. Two more, and last one. Okay, other side. One long line. When you lie in this position, you should only just see the tops of your feet. Feel like the leg muscles are engaging, even the underneath leg. That's not just lying there like a limp lettuce leaf. Point as you lift, flex as you lower. So both legs like ballerinas, engaging the thigh muscles, the calf muscles, as well as these hip abductors lifting the leg. Breathe out as you lift, breathe in as you lower. And shoulder down and away from the ears. Tummy muscles engaging. And imagine resistance on the way down so that you've got this something you're pushing into on the way down. Squashy beach ball or a massive marshmallow. Now you've got me thinking. To the top, draw circles for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And the other way, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And lower it down. So this was if you wanted the ball as an option or the weight between the ankles. Two legs lifting. Again, that might just be a step too far in itself. So if that's the case, you definitely don't want to add any resistance to it. You must feel like your legs are totally straight. The muscles are engaging in the legs. And that it's the muscles on the waist and the muscles of the center that are lifting the legs. So breathe out, reach, lift, hover. Breathe in as you lower. And last time. Very good. Hips and knees are flexed. We can add our elbow extension, the salute of the arm, with or without the weight, and then this opening at the knee. Remember, you've got a cup of tea on that top hip, so you don't want to rock back as you lift the knee. Imagine you've got a wall in the back of you and you cannot, even if you wanted to, rock back. Two more. And one more. Good. So lift the 2 feet if you wish it. Two more. Last two. And last one. And lower the feet, lower the, give it a pat. So the weight in the hand is optional again. You make your triangle shape, heel of the hand level with the knee, and have the fingers facing off at about 45 degrees. Breathe in to prepare. Breathe out, lift up and over. You take that side bend and really focus now on the waist on the underneath. Come on down. That's it. Breathe in at the bottom. Now keep your eyes looking forwards. So if you're looking at the ground, keep your eyes looking ahead. That's it. And then you'll see when I come down. So breathe out as you lift, push up out of the ground. And the lowering phase, slowly lower, really important to control the return, the descent. Perfect. So come to line your back and glue the legs together and rock the knees from side to side. That turning of the head, spiraling around the axis of the spine. And come back to the center. Let's place the foot onto the opposite knee. And the top foot, I like to draw the toes up towards the shin and then reaching through this eye of the needle stretch, reaching one arm through and then grasping underneath so that we're under the knee that has the foot on it, that has your foot up on it. Rest the head, and sometimes you need a bit more support to keep the neck in good alignment. Very good. Breathe in and out, hold, sustain the stretch briefly. And then let's swap sides. Same thing on the other side. Open the knee to the side. Hover, grasp underneath, drawing that leg in towards you. And have a rest. So hug the knees in. Let's come up to stand.
Very good. Come to stand with the feet under the hips, knees unlocked, tailbone to the ground, chest lifted. We're going to do our squat, tiptoe raise, squat, tiptoe raise, squat, tiptoe raise. That's it, great stuff. And reverse the arms, so I'm going the other way. Up, up, up. And this time we come up, let's stand and pause briefly, tiptoes lifted. And then lower the heels, press the walls away, grow the head to the ceiling, tail to the ground. Well done.